Dear students, welcome back. Lecture number 2 today. Understand? As you know, lecture number 1, we have already started chapter number 2. That is metals and non-metals. And in chapter number 1, in lecture number 1, I briefed you that this particular chapter of metals and non-metal has 3 sections. In our lecture number 1, we discussed about the first section, that is physical properties of metals and non-metals, that we already have discussed. Now today we are starting in our lecture number 2 today. Okay, chapter remains the same, that you all know. Let us mention the name again, but otherwise you know metals and non-metals. Okay, that's the chapter. Just to mention the name. And today in this particular chapter we are going to discuss about, in our lecture number 2, that is the topic which I write here, topic of general property we discussed. Now today the topic which we are mentioning is regarding chemical properties we are going to discuss today. Topic name, if I mention or not, everything is equal, but actually we are going to discuss chemical properties of metals, okay, and non-metals. We have to discuss chemical properties of metals and non-metals in today's topic. Now before we understand chemical properties of metals and non-metals, some of the important point which I want to mention is that non-metal, just for the time being let us forget, let us just think of metals. Before we start discussion regarding chemical properties, you all must be knowing chemical, why different metal possess different chemical behavior, chemical tendency or chemical property. So different tendency or behavior or properties of metal depends on their electronic configuration, as you must have understood in previous standard. Electronic arrangement or electronic configuration of atom of any metal actually represents its chemical properties. Okay, so different metals obviously different non-metals possess different chemical properties because they have different electronic constitution. They have different electronic arrangement, which we can say they have various electronic configuration. Because they possess different electronic configuration, they have got different type of chemical properties. Today, first chemical property which we are going to discuss today, understand that is, suppose we just give the number, because sometime you may refer textbook that time it has to be in your mind that this particular chemical property of metal we have already discussed. This first chemical property, let me make the title, it is actually a chemical property of, I am just mentioning the title of this property, reaction between, I am just mentioning the title, reaction between metals, understand, and reaction between metal and water. Understand, let us discuss this first, order may change, understand, we in textbook suppose 3.2.2, let us do that first, doesn't matter, we just want to discuss regarding ultimately the chemical property, number itself does not count a lot. Reaction between metals and water. As I always tell you in my lecture, in previous chapter also, that is in chapter number 2, acid, base and salt, at that time also I told you that whenever you want to explain chemical properties of any chemical property of metal, non-metal, whatever, at that time in discussing chemical properties of acid and base, I told you at that time that the general reaction has to be that the general word equation has to be written first. What is the title of this property? What we have written here? Reaction between metal and water. Before we start studying this chemical property, one thing is clear in your mind, that metal has different chemical properties. At the same time, when you discuss one general property for all metals, this is general property which we are going to discuss, that is reaction between metal and water. So even in these general properties of metal and water, all metal do not show similar chemical reactivity. Understand, no doubt the general explanation will remain the same. Actually, what happens? Let us try to generalize this. I am just writing, mind this, I am just writing general word equation of reaction between metal and water. What happens whenever we are just writing general word equation of reaction between metal and water? Whenever metal, any metal it can be, first whenever you want to explain any chemical property, you have to write general word equation first. Whenever metal react with water, whenever metal react with water, which are the product? So whenever metal react with water, it produces metal hydroxide. You should note down with me, metal hydroxide, and also produces hydrogen gas. This is called general explanation of this particular chemical property. This is general. Whenever any metal react with water, understand, and as I told you, as far as even physics, biology or chemistry is concerned, don't write anything until you understand it perfectly. When you have understood the content perfectly, you might be able to write answer in your own words, also factually correct. Okay? So what is the general explanation to this particular title, chemical property, reaction between metals and non-metals? So when metal react with water, it produces metal hydroxide and hydrogen gas. This statement you have to note down when you start your answer. If in exam it is asked, describe reaction between metals and water, so you should start with this. Whenever any metal react with water, it produces what? So it produces respective metal hydroxide, as well as it also produces hydrogen gas. Then you will write general word equation for that particular chemical property. You will explain it as metal plus water gives metal hydroxide, and it releases which gas? Hydrogen gas. Okay. Now one more thing which I should mention, why I am insisting and speaking the same general reaction again and again, because when you prepare some student query with me that from where to prepare objective itself are from subjective. Suppose you can make subjective yourself from here. Suppose I asked in one line answer, what are the products when metal react with water? So which are the product? metal hydroxide and hydrogen gas. I may ask another one line this way, which gas is produced when metal react with water? So which gas is produced? Hydrogen gas. This way you can explain the chemical property and you can also understand the one line or objective or fill in the blanks which can be asked from this. Understand? Now, as I told you that it has been a general explanation that any metal when react with water, it produces no doubt metal hydroxide and hydrogen gas. But at the same time I told you just now that every metal has got different electronic configuration, different behavior. No doubt this has been a general rule that any metal react with water, it produces metal hydroxide and hydrogen gas, no doubt. But if you compare different metals, they all show different types of chemical behavior during this particular chemical reaction, because you have studied in previous standard that all metals do not have similar chemical reactivity. To mention, suppose one by one if we start our discussion, suppose we take some metals, suppose this is clear, metal plus water produces metal hydroxide and release hydrogen gas. Let us try to evaluate the same chemical reaction in terms of various metal which show different chemical behavior. Suppose, take an example, I mention one, suppose sodium. When sodium react with water, H2O, it forms. From here you are able to ascertain the chemical equation. Sodium when react with water, obviously it produces metal hydroxide, that means it produces sodium hydroxide, understand, and it also produces hydrogen gas. This is the general explanation to this. Understand, for the balance, what will we do to here? So 2 hydrogen, 2 hydrogen, 4 hydrogen, 2 here and 2 here, equation is balanced. Balancing to it's easy for you. Understand? So when sodium react with water, it produces sodium hydroxide and release hydrogen gas. Understand? At the same time, why I am mentioning one another metal here? Because I want to make my point clear to you. Suppose potassium, when react with water, it also produces potassium hydroxide and release hydrogen gas. Balance as usual, you know. Okay, in both the case you see production of hydroxide okay. In both the case here sodium hydroxide is produced, here potassium hydroxide is produced. In both the case you see production of hydrogen gas. But one thing has to be very clear, why I mention both the metal here, the reason, in fact I must want to mention one thing, that during this chemical reaction both the metal sodium as well as potassium are such highly reactive metal, and you all know potassium is the highest reactive metal in the reactivity series. Sodium follows it, understand? So both sodium and potassium are highly reactive metal, so they do not require any extra parameter to react with water. They even react with cold water immediately, understand? Suppose this is cold water, no requirement of to supply any heat, anything else. They react with even cold water. So just try to understand this. Sodium and potassium are highly reactive metal in the reactivity series. As you all know, they immediately react with water and produce respectively sodium hydroxide and potassium hydroxide and release hydrogen gas. But mind one thing, the chemical reaction between sodium potassium with water is so highly reactive a chemical reaction that and during this chemical you can call it exothermic reaction, because in this chemical reaction sodium and potassium so vigorously react with water that lots of heat energy is produced at the end of the reaction, and heat energy produced at the end of the reaction may cause hydrogen gas which is produced to burn out immediately, understand? So this is actually no doubt production of hydrogen, but sodium and potassium react with water vigorously and produces hydrogen gas, and this reaction is highly highly exothermic chemical reaction. And hydrogen produced during the reaction due to the heat produced during the reaction, hydrogen gas start burning with popping sound, understand? So this is one aspect of this chemical property. Two reaction of which two metal we showed, sodium and potassium, which stands among the reactivity series in the highest position, potassium and sodium. Let us think of some other aspect for the same property, that is reaction between metal and water. Let us take the another aspect. We have already thought, understand, of two metal. Which two metal I thought? Potassium and sodium. Come in the lower order, suppose calcium also react with cold water. Understand, because calcium stands in the third stage in the reactivity series. Okay, now calcium also react with cold water, does not require the need of any extra supplement of energy from outside. It also react with water and produces calcium hydroxide plus hydrogen gas. Understand, balancing two hydrogen there, if we two hydrogen, okay, equation is already balanced. 4 hydrogen, 4 hydrogen, 2 oxygen and calcium. Here, my dear student, one thing, calcium is no doubt reactive, but not as reactive as sodium and potassium. So calcium no doubt react with cold water and produces hydrogen gas. The chemical reaction which is taking place is not highly exothermic as the previous one, but hydrogen produced during the chemical reaction stick to the particles of calcium. As a result, calcium particle start floating on the mixture on calcium hydroxide aqueous solution. So this is another aspect of how any metal react with water and produces hydrogen gas. Okay, so this reaction is not highly exothermic like that occur in case of sodium and potassium. Calcium also react, should I mention, also react with cold water. Suppose two aspects, we discussed about three metals here, so you can design any one line. Understand, like which metal react with cold water immediately and form metal hydroxide and produces hydrogen gas, so you know the name. Which metal can you mention? Sodium, potassium and calcium. Three metal immediately react with cold water even at ordinary room temperature and produces respective metallic hydroxide and produces hydrogen gas. Another MCQ can also be asked. Reaction of which metals with water is highly exothermic. So can you mention the name of two metal, which two? Sodium and potassium, which are highly reactive metal. Their reaction with water is highly exothermic one, and hydrogen gas produced during that particular chemical reaction will start burning due to heat produced, understand, in this chemical reaction with crackling or popping sound. Understand, so one line can be asked easily. Even what is the formula of calcium hydroxide, CaOH twice. Let us see the third aspect of this. You must have understood the second aspect. Understand, suppose which two metal we discussed, can you tell me? We discussed about sodium, we discussed about potassium, okay, we discussed about calcium, okay. If you see the metal reactivity series, understand, sodium, right, potassium, sodium, calcium. Let us see somewhat, if we come down in the lower order of the metal reactivity series, let us check the third one. Suppose, my dear student, Just take an example. Let me mention magnesium plus water, no doubt. Same chemical behavior of magnesium and water, ultimately again products are magnesium hydroxide and production of hydrogen gas, same way to balance, no doubt at all, same reaction, same type of product, means respective metal hydroxide is produced, no doubt, and hydrogen gas is also produced during this chemical reaction. But if I ask you one question, is it possible? Because magnesium lies in the fourth stage in the metal reactivity series. Is it possible that magnesium react with cold water? No. Magnesium is not as reactive as potassium, sodium, calcium. Magnesium do not react with cold water. Here the demarcation line. Magnesium react with only hot water. Understand, magnesium react with hot water and it produces magnesium hydroxide and release hydrogen gas. Understood? So you see the variation. If you are asked in exam, still we are continuing this, if you are asked in exam in 3 marks, describe reaction of metal with water. So my dear student, for fetching 3 marks, your answer needs to be very perfectly written, point to point. So if you are asked in 3 marks, your answer will start from general explanation. What was that? You must have noted down. What you noted down in your book? Whenever metal react with water, it produces what? Metal hydroxide and hydrogen gas. Then you have to write the word equation, metal plus water gives metal hydroxide plus hydrogen gas. Then in the second stage you have to mention that all metal do not show similar chemical reaction with water because different metals possess different chemical reactivity as per the metallic series, reactivity series. Then you will mention first aspect, that is reaction of highly reactive metal. Which was that? You remember the name? Sodium and potassium. Sodium and potassium react with even cold water and produces respectively sodium hydroxide and potassium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. But that reaction is quite exothermic and release lots of heat energy during that chemical reaction. And even hydrogen produced during that chemical reaction, understand, due to the production of heat, start burning with popping sound. Then I mentioned regarding calcium. When calcium react with water, it also react with cold water. But that reaction of calcium is not highly exothermic one, and during this reaction hydrogen gas which is produced will stick to the calcium particle and will start floating on the surface. And third one, magnesium. Magnesium also react with water, definitely produce magnesium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. But mind one thing very well, magnesium is not so reactive that it start reacting with cold water. Magnesium react only with hot water and it produces magnesium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. Understand? Now my dear student, if you still come down, understand, the some of the metal never even react, understand, with hot water. Just try to understand some very clear thing. Some of the metal, we come to the fourth aspect of the same chemical property. Understand, fourth aspect if I note down. Suppose my dear student, some of the metal if I mention, let me mention aluminium, let me mention iron, let me mention zinc. These all metal do not react either with cold water or hot water. They do not react with hot or cold water, then what? They react only with steam of water. That means they react only when water is in gaseous state. They no doubt react and ultimately no doubt produce metal hydroxide and hydrogen gas. That remains common for all this. But they react with steam only, aluminium plus water. You are able to write chemical equation, aluminium hydroxide plus hydrogen gas. Balancing, so you can learn yourself and you can do also. Iron again react with steam, understand, form iron hydroxide, understand, and release hydrogen gas. Zinc react with steam, produces zinc hydroxide and hydrogen gas. Everywhere the product remains the same, that is metal hydroxide, understand, as well metal hydroxide is produced as well as hydrogen gas is produced. Here one thing I should mention. So what happens actually when iron react with the steam of water, understand, it will produces iron oxide and hydrogen gas, okay? So this way you should understand. So actually what happened, you have to understand it very clearly. In both the cases, here also we have written this, but actually Al2O3. Here also just mind it, okay? Just a missing of that. Zinc oxide, balancing, so you can do it yourself, but mind one thing very clear. All these three metals, that is aluminium, iron, zinc, understand, react with water, but not water, they react with the steam of water and produces metallic hydroxide, metallic oxide and hydrogen gas. So little bit different chemical behavior here. Understood? So my dear student, you have to understand that these three metal which falls in lower in chemical reactivity series, understand, they do not react with either hot water or cold water. They react only with the steam of the water and produces respective metallic oxide and also produces hydrogen gas, okay? If you still move to the fifth aspect of understand the sum of the metal, if I mention, just take an example, gold, silver, copper, they do not react with water at all. Understand, they do not either react with hot water, cold water, steam of water. So one chemical reaction can be explained in five aspects. Reaction of sodium potassium with water, then reaction of calcium with water, then reaction of magnesium with water, then reaction of zinc, iron, aluminium with water. Understand, then reaction of gold, silver and copper with water. So everywhere when you are asked in 3 marks, you have to be very very conscious. Understand, and here mind it one thing, production of oxide can be Fe2O3 depending on the reaction, can be Fe3O4 also. Okay, so this way the first chemical property that we discuss, that is reaction between metals and water. Understand? So is it clear? So why in this one lecture we just discussed one chemical reaction? So for the knowledge of you, so that you can prepare any chemical reaction in detail, because any one line, fill in the blanks, MCQ are generated from explanation of particular chemical reaction. So when you prepare this general reaction of metal with water, you have to prepare it thoroughly. Each and every word, each and every product you have to learn, then you are able to answer any MCQ or any one line which can be asked. Okay, so today in our lecture number 2, today first lecture, that was general discussion of metals and non-metals, some general explanation about their physical property and some of the exceptional metals and non-metal. And then today in lecture number 2 we started regarding chemical reaction, chemical properties of metals and non-metals. Okay, we will continue the same topic, that is of chemical property, in our next lecture. Okay, so my dear student, thank you very much from Bharat sir.